Number 5.
India is inducting the first indigenously developed all-weather airborne early warning and control system. This is a major breakthrough for Indian forces. India has become only the fourth country to successfully develop an Aew&C system. In this video, defense updates will provide viewers with basic understanding of Aew&C system and focus on India's indigenous implementation.
Number 4.
Airborne early warning and control system basically have huge long-distance radars mounted on aircrafts. The radars are generally more powerful than those available in fighter or bomber aircrafts. The airborne system is designed to detect aircraft, ships and vehicles at long ranges and perform command and control of the battle space in an engagement. They mainly execute three duties: 1. Direct fighters and attack aircraft strikes against enemy assets or aircrafts in offensive role. 2. Alert ground stations and air defense forces with information of incoming hostile aircrafts in defensive role. These systems are equipped to provide recognizable air surveillance picture to the ground exploitation stations. 3. Analyze and record intercepted communications of enemy. These systems have two important advantages against traditional ground-based radars. 1. When used at altitude, the radar on the aircraft allows the operators to detect and track targets and distinguish between friendly and hostile aircraft much further away than a similar ground-based radar. 2. Unlike ground-based radar, which are static, these systems are much less vulnerable to counterattacks because of their mobility. This is why these are considered to be force multiplier, and are also known as eyes in sky.
Number 3.
In 2003, the Indian Air Force and Defense Research and Development Organization carried out a joint study of the system-level requirements and feasibility of development for an airborne early warning and control system. The government then approved the project for the development of the Aew&C system by DRDO. Primary responsibility for the project was with DRDO Center for Airborne Systems, which led the design, system integration and testing of the system. Electronics and Radar Development Establishment was responsible for the design of the radar array. Defense Electronics Application Laboratory was responsible for the data link and communication systems for Aew&CS. Brazilian-made Embraer 145 aircraft is used as the platform.
Number 2.
The system developed by DRDO has the following features. 1. The radar consists of two back-to-back active electronically scan array arrangements, with an additional dedicated identification friend or foe array. 2. The ESM, electronic support measures system, will be able to track sources with a directional accuracy of 2 degree RMS and a frequency accuracy of 1 MHz. 3. The electronic support measures component will have complete 240 degree coverage and have a database of up to 3000 emitters against which threats will be scanned. 4. CSM, communications support measures, will analyze and record intercepted communications both in flight and post-flight. 5. Self-protection suite will have a passive missile approach warning system, a radar warning receiver and countermeasures dispensers. The SPS will be integrated with the ESM and CSM suite. 6. The aircraft supports in-flight refueling, enabling it to cover large area for surveillance. 7. The aircraft will have SATCOM and data links to pass on ESM, CSM and radar data to ground stations and data links to pass on target information to fighters. More than 40 other aircraft will be data linked together by the Aew&C aircraft.
Number 1.
India is building three systems of this type. The second one is in the final stages of tests and certification, and third one is in last stages of development. The indigenous Aew&C project aimed to supplement the larger and more capable ELW-2090 WACS acquired by the AF from Israel. India operates three of these, which provide 360-degree coverage over a 400-kilometer range. Two more are in the process of being acquired. Noting the importance of Aew&C systems, India has taken further steps. Defence Acquisition Council, in March 2016, cleared building of two AWACS, which will involve mounting indigenous 360-degree coverage, ASA radars on Airbus A330.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.